As Nigeria celebrates 56th independent anniversary, Senator Kabiru Marafa from Zamfara State has said Nigerians should celebrate the leadership quality of President Muhammadu Buhari. Senator Marafa, in a chat with journalists, said the best thing that could have happened to Nigerians during the current economic hardship is the emergence of President Muhammadu Buhari.
I think the greatest thing, you know, we have today is the new government we have in place. The way it came in and the challenges it is facing today and the way it is handling the challenges, I think calls for a lot of prayers and thanksgiving and everything. Nobody thought maybe Nigeria will survive beyond maybe 2015, you know, given the way and the nature, you know, the election campaign was going on. But thank God here we are today with a new government in place and a government that is trusted by all and sundry. So I think it is a great blessing and we should thank God for it.
Meanwhile, Senator Ali Wamako from Sokoto State has called on all Nigerians to work together and provide solution to the current economic recession. Former Sokoto State Governor made the call while addressing journalists on Nigerian 56th Independent Anniversary Celebration in Abuja.
And to me, I can say the journey is so far so good. In the sense that as a nation, along our path of growth, we've encountered some smooth and turbulent moments. As a nation, we stood together, work together, and most of those turbulence are now put behind us. Of course, as today, we're battling with some problems of insecurity in some part of the country. We're facing the emergence of kidnap. It's a major crime in the country, in addition to reduce armed robbery as it was before. Above all, we're experiencing a recession which is biting hard across the entire country. And for me, in my honest belief, that the fact that we as people accept the fact that we are undergoing a difficult moment, and accept the fact that we together must work to find a way out of it.
Senator Wamako said Nigerians should be more dedicated, transparent in dealing with the recession.
By being more disciplined, more transparent, are more dedicated to find the solutions to the problem we find ourselves experiencing today. What I mean here, yes, we are in an economic recession, which was brought about by years of mismanagement, years of bad planning, and years of deliberate action of government to operate a mono economy. But today we all agreed that yes, we must diversify our economy as a way forward. Diversifying the economy means we intend to invest heavily in the field and area of agriculture.
The senator also called on the federal government to explore solid minerals resources as part of economic diversification. In Abuja, Muyiwa Bamdele reporting. Senator Solomon Adeola Olamilekan, representing Lagos West in the Senate, has called on the executive arm of government to embark on saving measures in order to save the country from further economic woes. In a chat with journalists in Abuja, Senator Olamilekan criticized the level of depletion of the country's sovereign wealth accounts.
We must save from every dime accruing to us as a nation. We must set something aside. Just yesterday, our Senate Committee on Finance paid a courtesy call to the National Sovereign Wealth Fund in their office. And our findings shows that for the couple of years we have spent as a nation, we have mismanaged our finances. We have torn down a lot of things that would have been a common wealth for all of us. And we notice that a country like Saudi Arabia, who in the 70s approached us for a bilateral loan, today is more solid than us as a nation. Knowing fully well that the main source of revenue of this nation is the same with us as a nation. Today, in the sovereign wealth fund account of country like Norway, is about $889 billion. While that of Saudi Arabia is about $740-something billion. And that of Kuwait is about $540-something billion. Angola, that just discovered oil about some 5-6 years ago, is having about $7-point-something billion in their sovereign wealth fund. But Nigeria, since 1960, that this oil has been discovered, to date, we only have a pantry sum of $1.7 billion.
On the proposed call for restructuring of Nigeria, the Lagos senator has thrown his weight behind the call for restructure. He explained that until the restructure takes place, Nigeria may not be able to address our numerous challenges.
I quite agree with those school of thought that say Nigeria needs to be restructured. Nigeria needs to be restructured economically. Nigeria needs to be restructured politically. And until that is done, as a nation, I largely believe we are deceiving ourselves. So I support total restructuring of Nigeria in its entirety. As I've said earlier on, we want to thank God Almighty who have kept us together as a nation, who has continued to ensure that the country, the entity called Nigeria, still remain intact. But we get if the legislature and the judiciary and the opinion leaders across the country that there is need for us as a nation to be restructured so that the going concern of this country will not be in doubt.
In Abuja, Muyiwa Bamdele reporting.
Hi, Mike.
Babe, it's been over 12 hours. Are you done thinking about it?
Convince me.
I know how much confidence style means to you. Let me take you somewhere.
What's that?
A superior leading international hospitality chain in the heart of Africa.
And?
They offer very distinct services. Their meeting halls and all their hotels offer conference solutions that can help plan a perfect function for any occasion. They feature outdoor catering and provide services for any size event.
Keep going. You got me thinking now.
The beauty, the decor, and the views. It's the hotel experience you always dream of. They have up-to-date entertainment and a variety served at the fast food restaurant and snack bar. Oh, and don't even get me started on the garden bar or the nightclub. You would have everything you need within your reach without having to go out.
Wow. So what if I want to...
Cook? They got you, babe. The rooms are thoughtfully furnished with facilities that aid proper cooking, just like you would at home.
Where is this place?
And it's sweet.
Wow.
So will you marry me?
Yes. How can I refuse?
Nanette Suites, a colorful affair.
Africa's economic growth is set to further slow down to 1.7% in 2016 from 3% in 2015, the lowest level in over two decades. World Bank Chief Economist for Africa, Albert Zoufarg, at the presentation of the bi-yearly African Pulse report said the new figure is an indication that the continent's economies are actually sliding back. According to him, the sharp decline in aggregate growth reflects the challenging economic condition in the region's largest economies and commodity exporters, namely Angola, Nigeria, and South Africa, who continue to face headwinds from lower commodity prices, tighter financing conditions, and droughts. Despite the headwinds, Zufac disclosed that some countries like Ethiopia, Mali, Mozambique, Rwanda, and Tanzania have continued to post annual average growth rates of over 6%, exceeding the top tercile of the regional distribution, and several other countries, including Cote d'Ivoire, have moved into the top tercile of performance. The bank urged the continent's policymakers to not only bolster medium-term growth prospects through structural reforms, but also address fiscal vulnerability and build buffers to withstand periods of global finance turbulence and tighter external finance conditions, even as he said that commodity cycle has ended.